Well, welcome back to Corkwing. Towards the end of February just now, and we're out in Loch Etive again. So the idea today is just fish the loch a bit, camp overnight, and then have a brief session tomorrow morning, pack it up about lunchtime, I think. So right now I'm well down Loch Etive, about a million miles away from the mouth of the loch. That looks awful like spurdog number one. Yeah, well, we'll better get it and see. It's a spurdog. Well, that's a nice mess to start with. Too bad. Yeah, I think it got away relatively lightly there. At least the line's not cut. So, pretty typical of the wee things you get in here. But I'll just pop them back, I think. Okay, I think this spot has had long enough, so I'm heading a couple of miles up the loch to give another marker a wee try. Something small and crab-like down there. We'll give it another drop and then move on, I think. these baits haven't been touched. I think we should just move. No point in wasting a day here. Cut your losses, I think. Pretty much fish of the day. Very little down there. We'll give it a wee while longer here and then head up the loch, find somewhere to camp for tonight. But I mean, it's been dire. That's the worst fishing I've had for ages in here. But we'll persevere for a wee while longer.
So I'm up beyond bars at a spot I've camped at numerous times before. I'm going to get the gear ashore and then row the boat up for tonight. I reckon I'll have a cast or two as I get the tent set up and then get some dinner sorted out. Well, it's an amazing evening with the stars out and the snow covering Ben Cruach and showing up beautifully. Fabulous conditions to be out camping. So back at the tent, the stove is getting the tent well toasty and cooking dinner into the bargain. Nothing very sophisticated tonight, just a one pot meal with chicken, pasta, chorizo, beans. But it's fine and filling on a pretty cold night. Plenty of it too. I've hauled in the baits now, so it'll be a wee fortified hot chocolate, and then I'm going to hit the sack. So basically I'm just going to see you guys in the morning, I think. Right, just going to get the stove going and sort out some morning coffee and then head down to the loch and get some baits in the water. Wow. Just caught a very quick shot of an otter before it clocked my boat and headed away. There is plenty of them in the loch, but they're pretty shy. I'll leave the rods while I pop some bacon and egg on for breakfast. First things first and all that. And the sun's just coming out. Might even warm up. So this is the favourite winter spot of mine, parked up in an old charcoal burner circle, close to the shoreline. It does get very midge infested in the summer though, so it tends to, as I say, it tends to be a winter, autumn winter venue.
Well, here's the evidence. So, We'll chuck another bait out, but I'm not very hopeful.
I'm quite often asked how I set up my overnight mooring, so I'm going to add a link to my website in the video description where I kind of go into it in a bit more detail. Well, this is definitely at your own risk, but it's actually quite a simple setup.
Well, that's the boat loaded, so I'll just get the shore gear on and go and pick up our anchor. Still pretty calm out there, so I'll we drift around, I think. But for now, let's see if there's anything except a crab on the end of this. Surprise, surprise, there actually is.
Just a small spurdog, but still pretty welcome.
Just fighting, being playing shreddies with the baits. Get a lot of rattles, but none of them are hooking. So, I'm just going to head ashore, get a bite to eat and a coffee, and have another cast with a shore rod. After that, I think probably just a wee drift longer and then back it in and head home. half of nothing. Not much of a surprise really. Except the crabs have had a go as well. Well, fishing on Etive's dire this afternoon, so I'm just going to call it quits and just head in. So, till next time, thanks for watching, and do remember to like and subscribe and all that good stuff, please. It does help.